It's a short list. The number of artists that can lay claim to being present in the delivery room for the birth of an entire genre of music. To take the collective ingredients present in the cupboard and create something truly original and send it out into the world? It doesn't happen often, and when the end result is truly special and unique, it leaves a mark on the landscape that alters everything in its wake. Poco's arrival in 1968 forever altered the fabric of American music and changed the trajectory of much of what came afterward. Other bands who owed their musical identity to Poco's influence were more commercially successful, yet, without Poco, the road taken by so many bands in the early 70s would not exist. Poco were the modern architects of the country rock blueprint. This is their story. Buffalo Springfield, the legendary L.A. band that counted Stephen Stills, Neil Young, Richie Furay, and Jim Messina among its members, were grinding to a halt as 1967 came to a close. The principal songwriters had resorted to finishing their tracks independently, and Furay and Messina, who were already contemplating a post-Springfield collaboration, extended an invitation to 22-year-old prodigy Rusty Young, who flew from Colorado to Los Angeles on 24 hours' notice based on a verbal recommendation to play pedal steel on a Furay composition, Kind Woman. Kind Woman was a musical epiphany, and Poco rose from the ashes of Buffalo Springfield shortly thereafter. Well, there's just a little bit of the new band included George Grantham on drums and Randy Meisner on bass, who left after finishing the band's debut to be replaced by Timothy B. Schmidt. Guitarist Messina would remain for two more records before departing as well, to be replaced by Paul Cotton. This lineup would record the band's landmark Good Feelin' to Know album in 1972. Half a century later, fans still consider this record a creative peak. Other bands who wore Poco's influence on their sleeves were surpassing the band in record and ticket sales, which frustrated Furay. He was later lured from the band in 1973 by David Geffen with the promise of building a CSN-like supergroup around him. The band continued as a quartet, leaving Epic Records in 1974 to sign with ABC, where they created a body of work that fans still count among their best. The early Rusty Young composition, Rose of Cimarron, and two singles that landed in the top 50, Schmidt's Keep on Tryin' and Indian Summer, a Paul Cotton composition featuring some of Young's most inventive pedal steel work. Indian Summer. In the summer of 1977, fate once again recruited Timothy B. Schmidt to replace original Poco bassist Randy Meisner, this time in the Eagles. After Schmidt's departure, drummer George Grantham ultimately ended up moving his family to Nashville to pursue the relative routine of session work. Rusty Young and Paul Cotton were the last men standing, and yet the band's most successful days were yet to come. 1978 saw the release of the Legend album, the first Poco record to be certified gold, featuring two bona fide hit singles, Paul Cotton's Heart of the Night, and a song that would remain at number one for 7 weeks on the Billboard Adult Contemporary charts. Written and sung by Rusty Young, Crazy Love would become the biggest chart success in Poco's history. It happens all the time. With Crazy Love and Heart of the Night cementing Legend status as a gold record, Poco had successfully reinvented the band formed out of the ashes of the Buffalo Springfield into a flexible cast of musicians capable of rendering acoustic ballads and guitar-driven rockers with equal adeptness. Having already taken on Charlie Harrison and Steve Chapman to replace their departing rhythm section, they added keyboardist Kim Bullard to become a quintet once again as they made the follow-up to the most successful album in the band's history, the record Under the Gun. This Poco lineup appeared at the Muse concerts at Madison Square Garden that would later be immortalized in the No Nukes film and contributed a song to the soundtrack of the movie Fast Times at Ridgemont High in 1982. Under the Gun yielded two Paul Cotton penned singles, the title track and Midnight Rain, before the band moved to Atlantic Records for the release of Ghost Town featuring the single Shoot for the Moon. Poco had finally achieved a degree of commercial success that had eluded them since their inception, but the musical landscape had begun to erode. The mid-80s saw the advent of MTV, and audiences' attention had been co-opted by the new medium. The band continued to make records for a time, but the earth was shifting beneath their feet, times were changing, and the 80s would come to a close before their star would ultimately rise again. In 1989, the original Poco lineup, Rusty Young, Richie Furay, Jim Messina, Randy Meisner, and George Grantham, reunited for the Legacy album. The album became the second gold album in the band's history, yielding two singles, the top 40 ballad Nothing to Hide, and the top 20 single Call It Love, co-written by current Poco drummer Rick Lonow. The band performed Call It Love on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson and embarked on a tour that included an appearance at Farm Aid. The reunion was brief, however, as Furay soon left to return to his leadership role at his church in Colorado, and Messina and Meisner returned to their individual careers. Poco wasn't finished, however. After reunionitis ran its course, Poco returned to quartet status. With original drummer George Grantham on board, Paul Cotton rejoined the band alongside Nashville songwriter and bassist Jack Sundrew, who had appeared with the band in prior lineups going back to the mid-80s, to form the Running Horse lineup. Running Horse was Poco's first record after a hiatus of a dozen years. The band self-released the album and continued to tour almost incessantly, including occasional guest appearances by various alumni. They were joined by Furay for a special performance at Nashville's Belcourt Theater, which saw a DVD release in 2004, titled Keeping the Legend Alive. Drummer George Grantham suffered a stroke on stage at an outdoor concert later that year that sidelined him, and the following year found Paul Cotton falling ill during a European tour, forcing him off the road temporarily as well. Cotton eventually returned, and the band has continued to tour, to record, and to release albums, including two live records from 2005 and 2006 before Cotton permanently left the band in 2010. A rejuvenated Poco with Michael Webb on keyboards and mandolin released All Fired Up in 2013 with songs written by Young, Webb, and Sundrew, who contributed a song from a prior solo album that soon became a crowd favorite, Hard Country. Hard Country tells of the struggles associated with holding on to a way of life, even as life itself presents obstacles to survival. Perhaps a perfect story to be told by a band that has weathered over half a century as an active touring and recording entity and bears the nearly singular distinction of having survived through the current day in early 2020 without having suffered a single casualty among the ranks of its past or present members. Poco has survived all these years, perhaps because, as Rusty says,
just take it day by day by day, my friend.
The limbs that have grown from Poco's branch on the rock and roll tree are innumerable, and their influence is profound. And it all happened because a 22-year-old kid from Colorado took a leap of faith and came to L.A. to play some steel guitar on a record. As Richie Furay sang on the opening song of the debut album over 50 years ago, there's just a little bit of magic in the music they're singing.